wonderful saving. All right, let's get ready to clock in. All right, we do always rise and give honor to the Most High, y'all. His son, Yeshua HaMashiach, always to all of y'all. Divine preachers in every place, preaching, teaching, living. Y'all's divine word, always to beloved ministers that labor with me in this part of the vineyard, who are not ashamed to call brethren, could dish greetings to them in their respective places. Always to those that are watching them by way of live internet, to the dispersed, to the scattered, to the Yehudians first, then also to the Gentiles, could dish greeting to them in their respective places. As we ought to say last, never least, to the way of Yah synagogue. Proper honor to you all in your respective places. Once again, from TV, internet, radio, wherever our voice can be heard, wherever we can be seen. Before we came on, had nothing come on. When we go off, absolutely. Ain't nothing else coming on. If they're not teaching Kodesh, living a clean, sanctified life, the people ain't in nothing and they hadn't heard nothing. This is an attempt
to collect the debt.
Whatever you hypocrite, false pretend, backbite, mumbling, grumble against will be used in that collection of a debt. These messages are always being recorded for quality assurance. It makes sure no side deals get cut with nobody. But everybody got to come in, Brother Red.
Out the door.
Straight, narrow path. All right, St. John 6:44. Make sure y'all have y'all pen and paper today. We're going to try to see if we can add some new words in. We're going to try. You know, I was thinking about this morning. If I can go back to the fifth grade, I'm going to be able to spell everything. Y'all, Joe, you good? You and CJ? I'm telling you, they're just going to be rallying off. I holler fifth grade, get your pen ready. It'll be coming. Hey, it'll be coming. Princess, you don't need to leave? You sure you don't need a break or nothing? But they're going to be just coming. So y'all make sure, I holler fifth grade, get ready. All right, everybody, this is St. John 6:44. Listen to the book.
No man
can do what?
Come to me.
Except
the Father.
Which have sent me.
Draw him.
Tell him what's going to happen, son.
And I will raise him up at the last day.
We talked about this before. Why we talk about this? Because he declared it in at the beginning. So the reason, again, why I've been constantly asking you guys about this, because you got to know him. Which means we learn a behavior. You got to think about something. People came into contact with him and knew who he was. They knew who he was. Because the only way they knew who he was because of the scriptures. Y'all got me? Because of the Old Testament writings. And really, we had to kind of be mindful about Old Testament, as they might call it. Because the mere fact that they used the words Old Testament, this is the reason why people don't obey it. We're going to say our law. We're not going to use old. Y'all got me? Because this is the way these people get out of obeying. See, Christianity actually came up with that development of old. Y'all got me? New, meaning get rid of the old. Y'all got me? We hadn't got rid of anything. This is our law. So everything that we read from the Hebrew Gospels through the epistle letters of the apostles all are substantiated by the law. Y'all got me? This is how we understand him, by the law. Y'all got me? So this is why it's important for us when we look. Certain words and word usage have meanings. Not only that, it has a way it will kind of play on your mind, way of thinking, how you begin to handle and understand the word. Y'all got me? A lot of times people say, well, we're going to go to the Old Testament. He said, we're going to go there, but we don't actually use it. Something better has come. No, everything that came based upon the law. Y'all got me? Let's see something right quick. While we talk, it's written, hold on. It is, I'm sorry, no man can come unto me except the Father which sent me draw
him,
and I will raise him up
at the last day.
Tell him what's written.
It is written in the prophets.
What's going to happen?
And they shall be all taught of God.
Plural or singular? Plural or singular? All right, let's see. Ephesians 4:4. I thank the Lord for a perfect way.
Amen.
Appreciate my good friend Leroy, if he's watching in. I'm looking to give you a call back. Just been busy. I appreciate it. Been a big help for me. This is Ephesians 4:4. Let's see what he said. Listen.
There is one body.
How many bodies is it, Brandon?
One body.
Can y'all show me one? Can y'all show me a number one? One? Okay. Come on.
And one spirit.
Can y'all show me a one? One spirit. What else happened?
Even as ye are called.
And one what?
One hope of your calling.
How many Lord?
One Lord.
How many faith?
One faith.
How many baptism?
One baptism.
How many God?
One God.
Who is what?
And Father of all.
Who is where?
Above all.
And where?
Through all.
And where?
And in you all.
One God. So when he said, it is written in the prophet, they shall all be taught of God. Are we talking singular or plural? We're talking singular. This is not discipline your law that you're going to learn by two gods. We're going to start Trinitarian doctrine now. There's only one God. There's only one body. There's only one call. So there's no way God called you and said, you be Baptist, you be Methodist. That's a different call. It's only one call. It's only one faith. Everybody that say got the same faith. Well, me and you don't really believe the same thing, but we both say that wouldn't even line up. One single thing, you know, it couldn't be another one. When God said, I stretch forth the heavens, I is plural, spread abroad the earth by single or plural. But when we take what they give us in Genesis chapter 1, in the beginning, Elohim, they're going to tell us the plural. That wouldn't make sense. He made and created. He said, I did that alone. I spread abroad the earth by my. So when he counseled, he had to be counseled with himself. If ain't but one, if there's another one besides him, there's going to be two. That's going to be against our just the only reason we find in the book of Isaiah. Spelling. Let's go. Fifth grade. Y-E-S-H-A-Y-A-H. Yeshiyah. That would be Isaiah. Yeshiyah. Y-E-S-H-A-Y-A-H. Yeshiyah. That is his Hebrew name. Yeshiyah. All right? So we got that. So now when we go back to look at what they told us at Genesis chapter 1, at verse 1, he just told us, there is but one body. Y'all got me? One spirit. Y'all got me? One faith. When you start looking at all these different things, they all derive from one place. One God, who is the Father of all, who is above all, who is in all, and through you all. That's going to get him. That's going to be the Father, the Begotten. That's going to get the Son that's in you, God with us. And that's going to get him as being the Spirit. He's in you all, through you all. Isn't that right? He came through us, right? Came through our loins, right? Came right down through the same lens, through and in you all. That's going to be the Spirit. What they tried to go and take and put in the book of Matthew, which is Matthew, by their call, but we're going to try to interchange so we'll start to learn to use. Y'all got me? Yeshiyah. When we go to Isaiah, call Isaiah, Pure, I want y'all to call Yeshiyah till we start learning to transition. Y'all got me? Because now we got to transition out of these people faulty teaching. Y'all got me? So now we're in the book of Genesis, but when we start looking at what he just told you, what they try to say, Father, Son, Holy Ghost, what you just find here in the book of Ephesians, the fourth chapter, he just gave you three different operations of him. Yet he told you ain't but one. Who is the Father? Who is the Begotten? He's the Son. He said, who's through you all, which means he came through. The book tells us in the seventh chapter of the book of Hebrew that it's evident that our Lord did what? So through you all, right? So he came through us, right? And he's in you all. That's the Spirit. Yet he told you it's only one. Y'all got me? These are not three distinct persons. These are operations of one. Y'all got me? This is why we had to come along and debunk all their lies. All right? All right, this is the book of Genesis. What does Genesis mean? It means the beginning of the start. This would be Latin and Greek, fifth grade. B-E-R-E-S-H-I-T. You're going to get two spellings for this word. B-E-R-E-I-S-H-I-T. T-H. Bereshit. It means start or beginning. This is the Hebrew word. Bereshith. You break it down, B-E-R-E, accent, S-H-I-T. This is one spelling. The other spelling you got was the B-E-R-E-I-S-H-I-T-H. This is our Hebrew word. Y'all got me? So we go to, when I say Genesis, what y'all going to say? Bereshith, B-E-R-E-S-H-I-T. This is one spelling. B-E-R-E-I-S-H-I-T-H is another spelling, okay? So it'll be two spellings for it. Y'all got it? It will mean beginning or start. Y'all got me? So let's see Genesis, I'm sorry, St. John chapter 17 and verse 1. Little by little, we'll transition. Y'all get it where it'll make sense. When you start, a lot of time, people go and try to learn Hebrew, they'll start picking up words you're not going to use. You'll learn how to say cat in Hebrew. How many times you going to call for a Hebrew cat? So I don't have time to learn it. Some things not going to be essential. We're going to look at things that are essential for us. People go learn door. How many times you going to use door in Hebrew? Anyway, a lot of stuff, people, car. How many times you going to use car in Hebrew? Let's use things that we're going to need. That's going to be necessity for us to know and know the meanings of that's going to be essential. Wholesome. What we tell you wholesome mean? Something promoting something essential. When y'all get cereal, years ago they said promoting a wholesome part of a balanced breakfast. Balance meaning essential. It means I'm giving you something that's essential to grow or health. You got me? So the words we're trying to look at, first of all, is a learning thing that's going to be essential for us as far as salvation. Y'all got me? Okay. This is St. John 17 and 1. Listen.
These words spake Yeshua
and
lifted up his eyes to heaven and said,
what did he say?
Father, the hour is come.
Come on.
Glorify thy son, that thy son also may glorify thee, as thou hast given him power over all flesh, that he should give eternal life to as many as thou hast given him.
What happened, son?
And this is life eternal.
That they might do what?
Know thee.
The only?
True Yah.
And who else?
Yeshua HaMashiach.
Whom?
Thou hast sent.
What did he say?
I have glorified thee on the earth.
Yes.
I have finished the work which thou gavest me to do.
Come on.
And now, O Father, glorify thou me.
You know what he did? Hold on for a minute. He said, what did he say that I do? I have did what?
Glorify thee on the earth.
And what else you do?
I have finished the work which thou gavest me to do.
Let me ask y'all a question. Had he done it? So what was he doing? Declare. So now you see what the prophets would be set you for. When the prophets would come, they would tell you the end at the beginning. Y'all see the point? These points were coming to show you I'm God, but we missed it. He just said he finished it. He just sat here and said, I've glorified thee on the earth. I've finished the work. Had he finished it? No, he hadn't finished it. But if you look at it, people think he's lying and he hadn't lied. I'm telling you, I'm God. When he told you no man has ever sent into heaven with the Son of Man that came down from heaven, which is where? He said in heaven. Where was he at? He had to be on the earth. We just sat here and said these words Jesus spake, Yeshua spake while he was where? He was here and he lifted up his eyes toward heaven. Why would he be in heaven lifting his eyes up toward heaven? You can't go no higher than where he was. Because I'm declaring the end at the beginning. I'm going to be there. What are we going to do with him? What are we going to do with him? That's why you got to have a teacher. You'll mess up. You'll mess up. See, he kind of lied. You going to hell. Isn't that right? You got to have a teacher. You'll mess up. He declared himself to already be there when he was here. We know he said, no man ever sinned in heaven except the Son of Man which came down from heaven, which is in heaven. He hadn't gone to heaven. We know that of a surety, even at the resurrection. He told Mary, don't cling to me. Why? He said, I have not yet ascended unto my Father, which I hadn't gone there yet. So I declare the end at the beginning. Makes sense when you start to read. A lot of times they read stuff. This is why people get thrown and they wind up pulling away. Because it contradicts. It's just not right. The book is not wrong. You got to know the law. We start off commonly it's written in the prophet that they shall all be taught of, which means now you need to know me. Every man, therefore, that had heard and learned of the Father. Why would a man like blind Bartimaeus call on him? Because he was blind? Had to be taught of him. So you don't have to have sight to know him. You just got to be taught. So a lot of things that we feel like you need in order for us to be saved are not essential to salvation. Walking, speech, seeing, possession. None of these things are characteristic for being saved. The people you'll find him that he actually interacted with were people that were without. He got a man that was a mute. Isn't that right? In the 9th chapter of the book of St. John, the man, he said, I got to work the work of him while it's yet day. Because the night coming, no man work when. The night. Why he use night? Death. People sleeping at night. Sleep, you're in an unconscious state. You're in a similitude of death when you sleep. You're not aware of your surroundings. You're not conscious. People that are dead are not conscious. They're not aware of their surroundings. Y'all got me? So that's why he said, I have to do what I do while I'm aware, while I'm not in an unconscious state. That's why it's so imperative when we come here that you guys come in conscious, that you guys come in here with a real ready mind. Because we behind. All the stuff that you got right now you're learning is not new. This is old stuff. I told you, we got more years going back than we got going forward. We've been driving for 400 years wrong. We turn around, we done start driving 1 mile the right way. Almost down. And what's bad about it, the 400 years we've been going backward, the way still been going forward. So once you ever get to your 400, you're still behind. It's kind of like when a teacher come in and get on the kids the last week, all trying to cram. Hey, y'all should have got this at the beginning of the school year. We're trying to cram something you should have got in the beginning. So now we come in trying to catch up. Y'all got me? Listen.
And now, O Father, glorify thou me with thine own self, with the glory which I had with thee before the world was.
So what word are we going to use him? Bereshit. Thank you. You just spake Hebrew. He just told him to glorify him with his own self, the glory he had before Bereshit. Y'all got me? Before the beginning, before the start. Make sense now? Now, what it made sense he'd have said before it was a Bereshit. Bereshit. He was Hebrew. Why wouldn't he not be speaking Hebrew? Right? So all these things we come back to look at and we start to consider. Right? The book of Exodus. Chapter 3. It's going to be rough, Leon. You're going to have to do some work today. I don't know how Leon going to get himself out of this one. This is Exodus chapter 3, verse 10. Listen.
Come now, therefore, and I will send thee unto Pharaoh, that thou mayest bring forth my people, the children of Israel, out of Egypt.
Listen.
And Moshe said unto God, who am I that I should go unto Pharaoh?
Come on.
And that I should bring forth the children of Israel out of Egypt.
Come on, son.
And he said, certainly I will be with thee, and this shall be a token unto thee, that I have sent thee.
Come on.
When thou hast brought forth the people out of Egypt, ye shall serve God upon this mountain. And Moshe said unto God, behold, when I come unto the children of Israel.
When I come where?
Unto the children of Israel.
Tell them what they're going to want, son.
And shall say unto them, the God of your fathers has sent me unto you.
Uh-huh.
And they shall say to me.
They shall do what?
Say to me.
They shall do what?
Say to me.
What they going to say to you, Andre?
What is his name?
What are we going to use him? Fifth grade. S-H-E. M-O-T-H. Shemoth. It means name. Names. This is the actual proper term for what they use for Exodus. Y'all got me? Shemoth. S-H-E-M-O-T-H. Second spelling. S-H-E-M-O-T. The H might possibly be there because of the pronunciation, Shemoth, versus with the T and you sound a Shemot. Got me? So we'll put both spellings. So when you go to the book of Exodus, it's actually Shemot. Y'all got me? It means name. It taught us Exodus means what? Coming out. That is not what, that's why that's what they use. That's not even the name of the book, it's Shemot, it's names. It's the names. That's the name of the book, it's the names. He told you at St. John, at Exodus chapter 6 at verse 1. That's all we got to do is teach people. We don't know. We hadn't known, Pastor. We hadn't known. When they taught us, that's what Exodus means. When y'all get ready to something, what y'all supposed to leave out of? Exit. Which is going to make sense for Exodus. Because they departed out. But this actually is the book of names. 6:1, Exodus. Listen.
Then the Lord said unto Moshe, Now shalt thou see what I will do to Pharaoh. But with a strong hand shall he let them go. And with a strong hand shall he drive them out of his land. And God spake unto Moshe and said unto him, I am the Lord. And I appeared unto Abraham, unto Isaac, and unto Jacob by the name of God Almighty.
Which would be El Shaddai. I appeared unto him by the name of who?
El Shaddai.
El Shaddai. What happened?
But by my name,
YHWH or YHVH,
was what I happened? Not known to them.
So now it will make sense when you say Shemot, because you just heard about Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. And he told you, I appeared unto them by the name of El Shaddai. But by my name, YHWH, YHVH, I was known. So Shemot would make sense because it means the names. Isaiah, Yeshua, Isaiah, chapter 9, verse 6. Woo, that was on time, Pastor. That was it. Yeshua, here. Yes, Lord. Isn't that right? Because y'all is Lord, ain't it? Y'all learn anything? This is Isaiah 9:6. Listen.
For unto us a child is born.
Unto who?
Unto us a child is born.
Yes.
Unto us a son is given.
We talked about that before. Unto us a child is born. Unto us
a son is given.
What we use here, brethren, we can use two words. We can use Reuben, means literally a son, or Moshe, boy baby. Isn't that right? Moshe, boy baby. It's really an argument versus on his name actually meaning drawn out or boy baby. Boy baby would be more likely simply because of what he said at the 18th chapter of the book of Deuteronomy. Hold me at 9:6. All we got to do, like I said, you got to watch. There's a lot of different things people put out here to throw us. So what we got to do is look at what's factual. You know what I'm saying? What would make sense for us? Looking at what Yeshua said, then we look at his speech. This is the book of Deuteronomy chapter 18 at verse 18. Listen to the book.
I will raise them up a prophet.
I will do what?
Raise them up a prophet.
I'm going to draw them out.
Raise them up a prophet.
I'm going to raise them up a prophet.
From among their brethren.
Listen.
Like unto thee.
Which means he's going to have to be drawn out. He's going to raise up a prophet like unto Moshe. So Moshe's name probability would be more boy baby. Because Yeshua just told us, listen, Yeshua 9:6.
For unto us a child is born.
For those watching, that's Isaiah. That's what you call Isaiah. So people watching, they want to know, oh, they think they're going to get, you're not going to get left behind. Everybody's going to grow together. Y'all got me? We all learning together. Isn't that right? Listen.
For unto us a child is born. Unto us a son is given.
Now this is going to make sense, right? Because now we're looking at Yeshua. He didn't say drawn out. He told her a son is given, a boy baby. Isn't that right? Because he said born. Isn't that right? Born. So born, it's going to make sense. It's a boy. That's what amazing when kids are boy, they give signs saying boy or girl. Don't say son or daughter. Don't it? And then what they give y'all for those that haven't knew, it say a boy or a girl. So it makes sense, boy baby, for Moshe. It makes sense that it's going to be that definition because he's got to relate to Moshe. He's going to be just like me. He's going to be a boy baby. He said, born. A son is given. And what happened?
And the government shall be upon his shoulder.
And the who?
The government shall be upon his shoulder.
Tell him about him, son.
And his name shall be called
Wonderful. So what we're going to use him? Shemot. Shemot. Because we're looking at names. Listen.
Counselor.
Counselor.
The Mighty God.
Mighty God.
The Everlasting Father.
What else, son?
The Prince of Peace.
The Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace. What happened, son?
Of the increase of his government and peace, there shall be no end.
To do what?
Upon the throne of David and upon his kingdom to order it and to establish it with judgment and with justice from henceforth, even forever.
That means when he got on the scene, that's it. We ain't looking for nobody to come sit on no throne of David. He said establish. And when he got on, he established it. Everybody else came through, reigned through, sat on it for a while, and they moved on. Once he came to say, he let her know upon that, that's going to be it. When he came to establish it, that's it. Y'all got it? Everybody good? Amen. So all these things we come back and we start to look at, right? That's why we're here. At the ninth chapter of the book of Leviticus. Let's see what that says. 9:1. Let's see what it says. 9:1. Listen.
And it came to pass.
What happened?
On the eighth day that Moshe called Aaron his son and his sons and the elders of Israel.
Mm-hmm.
And he said, he said unto Aaron, take thee a young calf for a sin offering and a ram for a burnt offering without blemish.
Uh-huh.
And offer them before the Lord.
Mm-hmm.
And unto the children of Israel thou shalt speak, saying, take ye a kid of the goats for a sin offering and a calf and a lamb both of the first year without blemish for a burnt offering.
Back me up at 9:1 again. Listen.
And it came to pass.
What happened, son?
On the eighth day.
On the eighth day. What is that for? Circumcision. What did happen, son?
That Moshe called Aaron.
That Moshe did what?
Called Aaron.
That Moshe did what?
Called Aaron.
He called who?
Aaron.
And did what?
And his sons.
And his sons.
And the elders of Israel.
Fifth grade. VAYIQRA. Vayikra. It means called. He called. The book that you call Leviticus. Spell it again. VAYIQRA. Vayikra. It means he called. So when you read the book, you notice that Moshe called Aaron and his sons. He called. Y'all got me? At the 10th chapter of the book of Matthew. Matthew, yeah, that's right. So we got to start break. We'll break the cycle. We broke it from holy, didn't we? We broke it from church. So the more we start to introduce to say and become kind of more accustomed to it, the more comfortable, the more easy it'll become. The more you practice something, just like drumming, guitaring, or karate, or anything, you know what I'm saying? Once you begin a football, any sport, once you begin to put it more into play, it becomes a natural. Y'all got me? So we had to start coming and put into play our Hebraic language. Got it? So it started to become natural to us, right? So at the book of Matthew, how do we spell Matthew? Awesome, you've done. You're not graduating this year. Mattityah. Y'all got it? How we spell yes, y'all? It's getting better. Don't worry about it. They got too many why. That's what I'm asking. This is 10:1. Listen.
And when he had called unto him his 12 disciples.
What did he do, brother? Vayikra. That's what he did. So he, Vayikra. We got to start putting it in practice. V-A, dash Y I Q R A. But Yigra. Y'all got it? Make a lot more sense when we go back, right? Little by little, we'll start looking what we introduce and we start to understand. God says, and see, when you do it this way, how the Lord get, it ain't something hard pressing on people. You know what I'm saying? It's something that you start to put and you start to calibrate or start to kind of introduce more into it when you start to look at these books, start looking at the Hebraic names, all right? Okay. The third chapter of the book of Hebrews. Kenfolk. Before you get there, give me the book of Numbers, chapter 14. See there, 14. Let me hear 14 and 1. The book of Numbers, chapter 14, verse 1. Listen.
And all the congregation lifted up their voice and cried, and the people wept that night.
Uh-huh.
And all the children of Israel murmured against Moshe and against Aaron.
Come on.
And the whole congregation said unto them, would God that we had died in the land of Egypt.
Yes.
Or would God we had died in this wilderness.
Yes.
And wherefore hath the Lord brought us unto this land?
Hold on. What did the Lord do now?
And wherefore hath the Lord brought us unto this land?
Y'all hear that? Wherefore had the Lord brought us into this land? Uh-huh.
To fall by the sword.
To fall by the sword.
That our wives and our children should be a prey.
Back up. Back up, Andre. Let's hear it again. 14, where you verse 2?
3.
Listen.
And wherefore hath the Lord brought us unto this land.
Uh-huh.
To fall by the sword.
Uh-huh.
That our wives and our children should be a prey.
Come on.
Were it not better for us to return?
Was it not better for us
to return into Egypt?
Was it not better for us to return into Egypt? Come on.
And they said one to another, let us make a captain.
Hold on for a minute. They said, back me up again, Andre. Let me hear 14 and 1. Amen. Come on.
And all the congregation lifted up their voice and cried.
Come on.
And the people wept that night.
Come on.
And all the children of Israel murmured against Moshe and against Aaron.
Come on.
And the whole congregation said unto them, would God that we had died in the land of Egypt.
Yes.
Or would God we had died in this wilderness.
In this wilderness. Fifth grade. B-E-M-I-D. D-A-R. B-A-R. Bamidbar. B-E-M-I-D, B-A-R, Bamidbar. It means wilderness. B-E-M-I-D, B-A-R, Bamidbar. At the third chapter of the book of Hebrews, Hebrews 3 and 7. If y'all ain't got the Most High, y'all working with y'all, I don't know who do. This is the third chapter of the book of Hebrews at verse 7. Y'all ain't going to believe it. I'm picking all this up from the book by off head. I picked these up to line them up off head. So I'm doing a lot of thinking going. This 3 and 7, Hebrews 3 and 7. And I appreciate the teleprompts always. Listen.
Wherefore, as the Ruach HaKodesh saith, today, if you will hear his voice.
Today you will do what, brother? What word we're using? Simeon. Today you will Simeon heard, hear his voice.
Harden not your hearts.
Listen.
As in the provocation.
In the what?
As in the provocation.
Yes.
In the day of temptation.
Yes.
In the wilderness.
What word we're using here? Bamidbar. B-E-M-I-D-B-A-R. That'll be in the wilderness. Y'all got me? Woo, that tight. See it for Deuteronomy 4 and 1. Let's see what Deuteronomy 4 and 1 say. Listen.
Now, therefore, hearken, O Israel, unto the statutes and unto the judgments which I teach you for to do them, that ye may live and go in and possess the land which the Lord Yah of your fathers giveth you. You should not add unto the word which I command you.
You should do what?
Not add unto the word which I command you. Neither shall you diminish aught from it.
Fifth grade. D-E-V-A-R-I-M. Devirim. D-E-V-A-R-I-M. Devirim. It means words. So when Moshe would have told them at 4 and 1 again,
now, therefore, hearken, O Israel.
Therefore, O Israel, Simeon. To what?
The statutes.
The statutes.
And unto the judgments.
And unto the judgments.
Which I teach you.
Which I teach you.
For to do them.
For to do them.
That you may live.
That you may live.
And go in and possess the land.
And go in and possess the land.
Which the Lord God of your fathers giveth you.
See that? Which you wish the Lord your God giveth you. Listen.
You should not add unto the devarim which I command
so
you.
So we want to read it like it said. You should not add unto
the word.
Now he just told you to listen to the statutes and the judgment. Now he came and told you it was the word. The statute and judgment consists of what? Words. Y'all got me? So that's what devarim means. Devarim means. It means the word. So the book of Deuteronomy actually for us means, I mean, it's actually Devarim, and it means the words. Y'all got me? Let's see what he told you. St. John 6 and 62. Make it St. John 6 and 60. Man, y'all gonna be so Hebrew, they don't know what to do with y'all. Therefore, man, you'll slap the Devarim out of their mouth. I kick your behind all the way back to the Bamidbar. Where that gonna be? Kick your behind all the way back to the wilderness. Y'all good? Listen.
Six and sixty.
Listen.
Many therefore of his disciples.
We did what?
When they had heard this.
What happened, son?
Said, this is a hard saying.
What happened?
Who can hear it?
Who can hear it? Who can Simeon it? Come on.
When Yeshua knew him, when Yeshua
knew. For those watching, you hearing Yeshua, Jesus is the name of a slave ship in the 1500s. It would make absolutely no sense that they would be speaking in early AD talking about Jesus. Nor would he bear the name. This would be a 1500 name in Christian era. Y'all got it? This is Christian era. Not time, this is their wrong. Y'all got it? So this is when you watch. It's a lot of people that watch us for the first time, been watching. They kind of get thrown when they hear certain names said. Yeshua is the shorted part of the word Yehoshua. And that right is the name that Moshe would have given who they call Joshua. Yeshua means he saves. Yehoshua, Yah's salvation. Right? So we had to look, it would make sense, it would say he saves. Because the scripture told us that you shall look on him whom they have pierced. Who? Him. He saves. Only you had to look on him. He told you, look on me, all the ends of the earth, and be ye what? Saved. Who? Him. He. He saves. That's why we had to look at him. He saves. Who is he? Yehoshua. What is Yehoshua? Yah's salvation. Make sense? These people don't know what they're doing. They go and they put his name Yahshua because you're an idiot. That's not his name. People go and make what they want to put it. He said, I come in my father's name. He did. Isn't it? He did. And in Revelation chapter 1, verse 7. In St. John the 5th chapter, he said, I come in my Father's name. He did it. Let's see what he told you. Revelation 1 and 7. Listen.
Behold, he cometh with clouds.
And every
eye shall see him.
He cometh with clouds. And every eye shall see them.
Shall see him.
Him. Back to one. What happened?
And they also which pierced him.
Uh-huh.
And all kindreds of the earth shall well because of him.
Listen.
Even so, amen.
So be it. That's what John said. Amen means so be it. Come on.
I am Alpha and Omega.
Greek. Would it make sense if he spoke Greek? He said, I'm Alpha. You know. Omega. It made no sense he'd have said that. It made sense he'd have been the first. Alpha is Greek for first, one. Last, Omega, this is still Greek. Y'all got it? So he would tell you, I'm the first and I'm the last. What happened, son?
The beginning and the ending.
The beginning and the ending. Come on.
Saith the Lord.
Saith who?
The Lord.
Who is the Lord? Come on.
Which is.
Which is, still which, am. Come on.
And which was.
And was at the beginning. What happened?
And which is to come.
And the same one is to come. Who is that, Brandon?
The Almighty.
That same one appeared unto Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. So he came in the Father's name. He just told you, well, he's something Almighty. If I'm which is, am presently, which was, I was before, and which is to come, I'll still be. Who are you? The Almighty. El Shaddai. That's what he appeared to Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob and told him. You were just taught this. Right? In the sixth chapter of Shemot. Shemot. Right? What does it mean? The name. The names. So he was just taught that in the names. When he went back over our fathers, he told you clearly who he was when he appeared unto them. So he let you know which was. Y'all got it? Which is, I am. And which is to come, I'm still going to be the Almighty, El Shaddai. So he did fulfill it. He came in his Father's name. Y'all got me? Come on, finish up that St. John 6. We're looking for 661.
Amen.
Let them get it. St. John 6 and 61. Listen.
When Yeshua knew in himself that his disciples murmured at it, he said unto them.
What did he say?
Does this offend you?
Does this offend you? Or did he ask, does this also offend you?
Does this offend you?
Come on.
What then if you shall see the Son of Man ascend up where he was before?
Tell him what quickeneth, son.
It is the Spirit that quickeneth.
Y'all hear that? It is the Spirit that quickeneth. Come on.
The flesh profiteth nothing.
The what?
The flesh profited nothing.
Talk to me, son.
The words that I speak unto you.
Wow. What are we going to use? Diverum. That's what he would have told them. It made sense he would have said that, wouldn't it? The words that I speak unto you, they are what?
Spirit.
And they are what?
Life.
What are the words he going to be speaking on except for the law, statute, and judgment and commandment? Makes sense? Because it's got to tie into what we've been taught. So you can constantly see the same pattern of behavior. Y'all with me today? At the 46th chapter of the book of Yeshua. What book is that, brother?
Isaiah.
Listen.
Baal bowed down, Nebo stoopeth, their idols were upon the beast and upon the cattle.
He said Nebo stupid. How did it make sense for y'all? He talked about Baal, then he said Nebo stupid. He said they're what?
Idols.
What were y'all taught about this? What were y'all taught about Nebo? This was one of the names given to the Hebrew boys. Meshach, Shadrach, and Abednego. These are idol names. These names are worshiper of idols. That was not their given name. These were names that were given to them when they went into captivity, which would make sense for you. He just talked about Baal. You know about Baal, right? Which was an idol, right? Then you know about Nebo now. He told you their idols stupid. They cut down. So they named the Hebrew boys after idols. Those names they give you, Meshach, Shadrach, and Abednego, those are not Hebraic names. Those are not names that they had and they gave to themselves. Those were names given them by their captives. Y'all got me? Just as with Esther. Esther's name was Hadassah. Esther also has another name besides light or shining. It's also tied into idol worship. False gods. So a lot of stuff we had to come back and watch, DP. It makes sense to come back and say he's going to give us a new name.
Amen.
Better than that of the sons of men. You got to watch our captain. These people are swift. These people are cunning. These people are crafty. Y'all all right? Also, you'll learn Jeremiah. Fifth grade. Lord have mercy. Y-I-R-M-Y-A-H. Jeremiah. Y-I-R-M-Y-A-H. Jeremiah. That is his name, not Jeremiah. They'll tell you all of them had Yah in their name, but they ended with I-A-H. It will be with a Y. Just like with Israel, it'll be with a Y. You wouldn't spell Yah with an I. You spell it with a Y. So they all named Isaiah, Jeremiah, but they always ended I-A-H. It's Y-A-H. Y'all got it? Thank the Lord. Come on, finish the 46th chapter.
Their idols were upon the beast and upon the cattle. Your carriages were heavy loaded. They are a burden to the weary beast. They stoop, they bow down together. They could not deliver the burden, but themselves are gone into captivity. Hearken unto me, O house of Jacob, and all the remnant of the house of Israel, which are born by me from the belly, which are carried from the womb, and even to your old age I am he, and even to hoar hairs will I carry you. I have made and will bear, even I will carry and will deliver you.
Come on.
To whom will ye liken me and make me equal and compare me that we may be like?
You hear that? I'm going to take a white man, put him on a stick, and say that's him. I'm going to get some hands and put them together and make them of gold and say, this is like him. You see how all these things go contrary. This makes sense because our Lord told us. In the day when he spake to our father, he said, you saw no image, lest you would corrupt yourself. So when Yeshayah would have started talking to concerning this, he's bringing us back to look at, I don't know how you ever got any pictures. I don't know how you ever got anything and you put together and say, that's likened to me. I'm the one that carried you from the womb. I'm the one that brought you from the belly, from your old age. I've done all these things. Now, who are you going to liken me unto? He tell you all these idols these people sat down, they were all destroyed.
Amen.
Even the book of Psalms tell us that the Lord, that all the gods of the nations are what? But the Lord, our God, he made the heavens. So who are we going to liken him unto? Come on.
They lavish gold out of the bag.
Wow. Look at them gold crosses. Them gold hands. Everything they do. Come on.
And weigh silver in the balance.
If it ain't gold, it's silver. Come on.
And hire a goldsmith, and he maketh it a god.
See that? That's what they do. They go hire somebody to come in and formulate and say, I want you to make my Jesus. I want you to make this who saved me. This who brought me out. He said, who you going to liken me unto? Come on.
They fall down. Yea, they worship. They bear him upon the shoulder.
Wow. Come east of what they're doing. Folks walk around old rugged cross on their shoulder carrying. Everything he told her they do now, they've been doing it. This is what's bad. When he would have declared this to Yeshayahu would have declared this, he hadn't even came and died yet. Listen.
They carry him and set him in his place, and he standeth. From his place shall he not remove. Yea, one shall cry unto him, yet can he not answer, nor
Lord,
save.
How many times folks been guilty of praying that thing? That pickle on the stick. Nations cry. Earthquakes, tornadoes hit, floods, everything. They fall right down. They pray to that jigger, pray to that nigga. Pray to that pickle on the stick, drained. I ain't got a drip of blood in it. They got dashed tomato juice on it. And he said the sad part, he can't even answer. You see how backwards we've been for years. You know what the sad part, though? This was him when we were doing it. I used to have a cross. I had a nice one. I was preaching. I want people, they saw it, they said, I know you're a child of God. Isn't that right? You rub it, you talk, kiss it. Somebody see that, you want me, they said, oh, that fella sanctimonious. Instead of that nigga sick in the head. He like kissing pickles. I'm just look at how we've been brainwashed. Come on.
Nor save him out of his trouble.
Look at, he can't even save himself out of his trouble. Come on.
Remember this and shew yourselves men, bring it again to mind, O ye transgressors.
Uh-oh. Come on.
Remember the former things of old.
Remember the former things of old.
For I am Yah, and there is none else. I am Yah, and there is none like me.
Y'all hear that? It ain't nobody you can make like him.
Amen.
What happened, son?
Declaring the end.
When?
From the beginning.
Come on.
And from ancient times, the things that are not yet done.
Look at that. I done declared already before you did it. So when you went and made that pickle on the stick and put it on your shoulder, didn't I tell you you were going to do that? I told you the Ethiopian was going to walk with their butts out to Egypt's shame. I told you before it even happened. And you know what people miss? Revelation chapter 1 is the beginning. You know what he told you? He already let you know that he the one to come. He already told you everybody going to be on the earth, they're going to be mourning and weeping. I told you that before I even got through, started telling you about all the different battles. Before I told the angel to hold back the four ends of the earth. When I told you how Satan was going to come down and how it was given in his hand for a season, I already told you how the end going to be before it even got down. Y'all all right?
Amen.
That's what we sat back to consider. We consider the latter end. That's what he tried to tell her. Consider your latter end. And a lot of times, that's what we miss. We get caught up in the formulation of what we got to go through. Look at the latter end. What is my reward? When you start, I told you before, it gets bad when you start allowing your labor to become greater than your reward. The reward shall outweigh the labor. I tell you, I don't need a job. Ain't no way I'm working a job going to pay me less than what I'm doing. That's crazy. I ain't going to do no $29 hour work for no $5. I can't do it. It don't make sense. I'm a mom or my grandma. I'm going to complain. I ain't going to do it right. I ain't going to be happy. And guess what else I ain't going to do? I ain't going to do it alone. So if I do something, it got to equal out to what I'm looking to get. My pay going to have to be greater than my labor, or they're going to have to be equivalent to. What you do for God is less than what you're going to get paid. Huh? You're doing less than what you're going to get paid for. You're going to get paid a whole lot more than what you're doing. Y'all hear me? That's why he was able to endure what he did.
Amen.
The book told her, consider him which endures such contradictions of sinners. Huh? All these different things. He looked at the labor was greater, the reward was greater than the labor. Y'all got me?
Amen.
When he talked to the young man, the rich man, he told him when it came down to concern the commandments, he asked which of these, he said, all these I kept from my youth up. After he did that, what he told him, he said, what lack I yet? He said to do what? Go sell that which thou hast, and thou shalt do what? And thou shalt have treasures in heaven. He ain't going to have no suffering.
Follow me.
He ain't going to have nothing he going to go without and go through. We declare the end at the beginning. We're looking at the end. We got to look at the end of it. Of course you're going to have to go through it. Ain't no way in the world I'm going to set everything on heaven and ain't going to suffer. My whole life going to change if I get rid of everything I got. Where I stay going to change. My address is going to change. What I drive is going to change. The people that I deal and I socialize with gonna change because I don't have the same status. I don't have the same possession. But what I gotta put and I gotta wear everything on, the end. I'm looking at the treasures I'm gonna have with God. Huh? That's important because he told me where a man had heart at. So if I'm gonna have treasures in heaven, that's where I gotta put my heart at. In the third chapter of the book of Colossians, I can help y'all out if y'all listen. Y'all ain't going to believe how many folks ain't already sleeping. I told my wife, and she was explaining to me. I said, you back there? I said, you was going like that? I said, she said, but I owe my eyes back up there. I said, yeah. She said, so was I sleeping? I said, whatever you want to call it. So I guess I'm getting them. They think of sleeping. They looking at a pillow kicked up, leg caught, going, I apologize. I'm talking about eye closed, and you left him for a minute. Like Albert told me, I am not sleeping. This is how I concentrate. I said, come on, Albert, you got to get out of here, man. He'll come with a big old paper with all that drawing. I teach the mysteries of Daniel. Like, man, shut your mouth. You're an adulterer. Everybody know adultery team. Shut your mouth. You're a transgressor. Isn't that right? This is Colossians chapter 3 and verse 1. Listen to the book.
If ye then be risen with the Mashiach.
See that? If you then be risen with the Mashiach. And you know what else he told you? Why this important? What did y'all hear concerning this? If you then be risen with him. Did y'all hear anything today that kind of correlate with that? Huh? That's good. What else? Moshe told y'all what he said he gonna do. So then if you then be risen with the
Mashiach.
Listen.
Seek those things which are above.
Where who? So where now we just heard y'all gonna have treasures in heaven. The only way you're gonna look at being resurrected, there's gotta be a death. Right? How you gonna be resurrected if there's no death? That wouldn't make any sense. He told y'all, except the corn of wheat fall into the ground and die. That's why we use the correlation of raising up. Right? It's got to come up from the ground. Y'all got me? And I will raise him up in the last days. So in the last day, I'm going to raise him up. That's going to be the harvest. Ain't that right? That's got to be in gathering. We told you, it's only twice a year we gather. Right? At the beginning of our summer and toward the end. Right? That's in the end of our year. When it's the end of our year, not the year ending, that's the last time you can gather. So we look at these things. We have expectations. That we had our first gathering. We expectation now is for the last gathering. That's what we look at to carry us over for the winter. Come on.
Where the Mashiach sitteth on the right hand of God.
Mm-hmm.
Set your affections on things above, not on things on the earth. For ye are dead, and your life is hid with the Mashiach in God.
Listen.
When the Mashiach, who is our life, shall appear,
then
shall ye also appear with him in glory.
Mm. What he wants to do?
Mortify therefore your members.
What do we do when we say mortify, brother? Kill them out. Gotta die. Gotta let these things die. Mortify therefore your members. Come on.
Which are upon the earth.
Yeah.
Fornication.
We had to get rid of it. These come in from behaviors we learn from the word. Because now we have to start looking at what is our expectation. Our expectation is to be with him. Right? Our expectation is to reign with him. Well, if that's our expectation, then there's some things that qualify you to be able to do these things. Then you have to kill out some things, which means in order to kill it, it's got life. You don't kill things that don't have life, right? It's already dead. You kill things that have life. All these are attributes that we're guilty of having or possessing. So now he said, in order, if you then been risen, if you then be risen with the Mashiach, seek those things which are above, where the Mashiach sit on the right hand of. What word we use, brother? Benjamin, son of my right hand. Right? So then you got to start looking at what you got to begin to do. You got to get rid of certain behaviors. Come on.
Fornication.
Uh-huh.
Uncleanness.
Come on.
Inordinate affection.
Inordinate. What are inordinate? Unusual. Unnatural affections. Come on.
Evil concupiscence.
Evil concupiscence.
And covetousness.
And covetousness.
Which is idolatry.
Which is idolatry. Come on.
For which things sake.
The wrath of who?
God.
Cometh upon who?
The children of disobedience.
The people that were taught this and they still go and violate it. That's where the wrath come on. So we're here to be taught, as he told us, it's written in the prophet, they shall all be taught of Yah. So every man therefore that heard it coming to the Father, every man that heard and learned of the Father, cometh unto me. In order to come, then there's certain things you learn, what are requirements, what are things you have to get rid of, what things you have to do in order to make the transformation. That's why we're here. Y'all got me? Let's look at something right quick. 12th chapter of the book of 12th chapter of the book of Deuteronomy. Deuteronomy 12 and 1. Wonderful Savior.
Amen.
That's right, Deuteronomy. Devarim. for the book of Deuteronomy. So we go and we start to put the book together. We're looking to have these names at the first page of them. So you'll become more comfortable when you see them. I don't know if we'll be able to have it on every page. Maybe a slash with the Deuteronomy behind it or the slash with all of that way you become accustomed to seeing it. Y'all got it? Okay, let's see. Listen, this is the 12th chapter of the book of Deuteronomy, verse 1. Listen.
These are the statutes.
And what else?
Judgments.
And the judgment.
Which ye shall observe to do in the land.
Which will make sense. These are the words. Come on.
Which the Lord God of thy fathers giveth thee to possess it.
Yes.
All the days that ye live upon the earth.
Come on.
Ye shall utterly destroy all the places wherein the nations which ye shall possess serve their gods. Upon the high mountains and upon the hills and under every green tree.
You know what they tell us? Leave it alone. Don't talk about what other people are doing. He told me to utterly destroy it. I wear their church out. I ain't getting any folk no brain. Folk want to say, a lot of people, you ain't even obeying. The devil room told me to do it. The word told me, he said, we supposed to utterly destroy it. How I rip it down. I don't have no pity for these people, no pickle on no stick. They can fall out for that thing and cry all they want to. I don't care nothing about it. You are a dumb nigga. You in the wrong. I'm going to utterly destroy it. You ain't serving the true and the living y'all. Y'all hear me? I don't know. Please, y'all hope none of y'all don't say be no transgressor. Y'all be feeling sorry for them people with that stuff. Everybody got a turn. I don't know about to feel sorry. Man, Eric, want me to turn. Everybody got an opportunity to hear the word, and you hear it, make sure you make the turn. Don't ever think the Most High, he wouldn't be right. He wouldn't be just if he didn't allow everybody an opportunity chance. Everybody make decisions. Stop sitting around thinking people didn't have a chance. People, that's a lie they told us.
Yeah.
Those are lies they told us. Everybody get a chance. You're going to hear some form of the word. It's up to you what you do when you hear it. You got to make decisions. Like I said, the day you hear my voice, harden not your heart.
Amen.
As in the provocation, in the day of temptation, in the what, brother? Bemidbar. In the wilderness. That's why I put them in the wilderness. And they saw my work. How long? Wherefore I was what? I would grieve with them. I would grieve with them. Because I sat there and I told them. They knew and they didn't do it. Don't let these people make no fool out of y'all. Come on, son.
And ye shall overthrow their altars.
And what else, son?
And break their pillars.
Uh-huh.
And burn down their groves with fire.
Mm-hmm.
And ye shall hew down the graven images of their gods.
Come on.
And destroy the names of them out of that place.
That's why we rip it out of him. We get Jesus out of him. Amen. He's going to destroy. Get their name out of these places.
Amen.
In a slave ship. Why in the world we sit around and we worship a slave ship? Can y'all believe we were baptized in the name of a slave ship? I baptize you in the name of Jesus, you slave nigga. That's a slave ship. Man, somebody go to jail. Everyone these preachers that knew this and did, somebody be, you know it and you did it?
Mm.
That's crazy. You baptized in the name of a slave ship? You taught us to pray to a slave ship. You told us to call on a slave ship. When we were sick, get your healing from a slave ship. If you got problems, call on the slave ship. When you're feeling all and you need a friend, call on a slave ship. That's an insult, dogs.
Amen.
That's an insult, dogs. That's a straight atrocity. Nobody's saying nothing about this. And these guys know this wrong and they doing it to us. Lord, have mercy.
Amen.
I don't feel sorry for him. Listen.
Ye shall not do so unto the Lord your God.
We don't take in Yeshua's name and tear that down.
Amen.
We're not going to tear down the name of y'all now. We're not going to do
Amen.
That. That Jesus nigga. Rip a ship down.
Amen.
I sink that Titanic.
Amen.
Ain't that right? If you spotting Jesus, you're on the Titanic. It got to go down. Listen.
But unto the place which the Lord your God shall choose out of all your tribes,
what do you
put
want
his name
to?
There.
What happens, son?
Even unto his habitation shall ye seek, and thither thou shalt come.
You hear that? That's why we got to try to make our way back to Jerusalem. Jerusalem, we got to make our way back there. He said where he placed his name, he placed his name there. He said there we supposed to seek after. So when it came to us being dispersed out, when he told us we begin to bethink ourselves in the latter days, he going to come and fetch us because now we start to consider, where is his name at? What was the place he established for us? All these things are we looking for. We're looking to go back. He said, now we're supposed to be seeking. It made no sense for us to try to seek none of this old ungodly place that these people got. The best of them, just like the book of Micah, is as a briar. The most upright they got is just like a thorn in the head. They ain't got one person that can show you upright. They ain't got one clean, righteous Christian they can show you. One of them, not one. Church of Micah ain't called back yet. All I ask for one man. Like dicks and pricks, them Mises. All them done Mises ain't got nothing clean. Y'all remember dicks and pricks? What name that cat you to call him? What's the name of that cat?
Wow.
You can leave now. Dixie and Pixie weren't on no Tom and Jerry. That was the first talking cat. Now they said Tom talking. I wouldn't watch it. Listen.
And thither ye shall bring your burnt offerings and your sacrifices and your tithes.
Come on. And your tithes.
And heave offerings of your hands.
And your heave offering of your hands.
And your vows.
And your vows.
And your free will offerings.
And your free will offerings.
And the firstlings of your herds and of your flocks.
Come on, son.
And there ye shall eat before the Lord your God.
Yeah.
And ye shall rejoice in all that ye put your hand unto.
Come on.
Ye and your households, wherein the Lord thy God hath blessed thee. Ye shall not do after all the things that we do here this day.
Y'all hear this? Oh, so we can't do the stuff we've been doing now. It's not the day. He was preparing and letting them know already what was going to happen. Now, we get to the place where we're supposed to go, you're going to bring all your tithes. You're going to bring all your heave, all your vows, everything you got, you're going to bring it. He said, we're going to eat before the Lord. He said, what we're doing today, we ain't going to be able to do that no more. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. See, that ain't nothing new with me. Old thing going to pass away. All thing got to become what? He ain't saying we ain't done it. So we can't do it no more. Hold, you got 18th chapter book of Leviticus. Vayigra. V-A-Y-I-Q-R-A. Vayigra. 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 What does it mean? Called. Huh? He called. We know who called. He said he called. Sometimes I watch these people, they add stuff. Sometimes the name won't necessarily mean all of it. They'll just say, since it said call, who else called but him? So we'll say he called. So I had to find out what is the word he for Hebrew. Got me? Would it be va? Let's go with called. Y'all got me? It's supposed to mean he called. Well, I had to watch. In the transit, we'll be, just write them down. Remember, any change that come up, we'll do. But take your time. It'll say he called. A lot of stuff I try to watch them, because a lot of times they'll add stuff. We still got a why. We got a lot of Yiddish people out here. And they'll put stuff in there they don't actually say. The Yiddish people can be just as dangerous. They'll teach you Judaism 101. Judaism. With Hebraic words, ancient words. And tell you no why, but this is Judaism 101. Did that make sense? Where's the school located? In Jerusalem. Does that make sense? And then they're going to be Israelis. Does that make sense? And they're going to be Jewish. Does this make any sense? But I'm going to be a scholar and a doctor in Hebrew, ancient Hebrew, language and writings. And I teach Judaism, and I'm Jewish from Jerusalem, and I'm an Israelite, Israeli. Is you really serious? I mean, it's bad. I mean, you just have to watch it out. People, you're saying, how exactly did that work? It doesn't make sense, does it? So we learn the transition. Come on, listen.
Leviticus 18.
Come on, 18:1. Listen.
And the Lord spake unto Moshe, saying,
what happened?
Speak unto the children of Israel,
which
say unto them.
Call the children of Israel and say unto them,
I am the Lord your God.
Which he's going to tell them, he's going to be Leviticus 18, Yavikra. You think about Devarim. Well, we got some work to do, don't we? We'll get it. Isn't that right? We just got to make it out of Bamidbar. Where is that? Wilderness. Bamidbar. You think about Bereshit. Bereshit would be beginning for Genesis. We're in the Bamidbar, in the wilderness. So we're trying to come out. Be like he told us in the book of Devarim, turn ye, take your journey. You've been in this way too long. Ain't that right? So we're trying to get out of Bamidbar. Ain't that right? By turning to the Devarim. Ain't that right? Which we should have buried sheep from the first. That makes sense? Well, I put that thing together. I scared my doing self, fifth grade. Come on, fifth grade. Listen.
And the Lord spake unto Moshe, saying,
what happens, son?
Speak unto the children of Israel,
yeah,
and say unto them, I am the Lord your God.
Uh-huh.
After the doings of the land of Egypt, wherein ye dwelt, shall ye not do.
Y'all see that? So it would make sense when Moshe would have told us that we won't do it after that day. Because see, when he called, that's what he was calling us to do, to teach us, to tell us, to let us know these things here, you won't be doing anymore. You come, I know, I remember we used to do, I know, you won't be doing that anymore. All the different behavior, all of the things we were doing when we were with the Egyptians, he said you won't be doing it anymore. And the way to do that was to separate us. The way, in order to keep us from doing it, he had to give us particulars. He had to give us the Devarims, because the Devarims were going to show us and were going to teach us what we were to do and not to do. What we would destroy? Everything what these people worship, everything these people have, everything they set to follow, tear it down. But the things that the Lord thy God has shown us, and he said his name now, he said, shall you not do. The Devarim started to give us behaviors. Once we were called, y'all got it? So we start learning what to and what not to do. Y'all got me? Where you at now? Still at 18? Listen, and we'll go right. We'll go back on to the 12th chapter of the book of Deuteronomy. Deuteronomy chapter 12. We wait. Yosha said, I'll start to say it. What you thinking of though, Yosha? Y'all gonna let these sit. You already down? All right. What about you, Hayward? Make sure you beat your wife when you get home. It'll help you remember these books better. Listen.
At verse 8.
Come on.
You shall not do after all the things that we do here this day.
See that? Not the things we do, not this day. Come on.
Every man whatsoever is right in his own eyes.
Y'all hear what happened? What were they doing? He said, we were doing everything we want to do. Everybody was declaring and doing what they want to do. That's why the word had to come, Devarim. That's why it was important to get the word. He said, out of the day, we ain't going to be able to do. Everybody do what you want to do. What you want to do? Well, what you want to do? Everybody been doing what they want to do. He said, out of the day, we can't do that. Come on.
For ye are not as yet come to the rest and to the inheritance.
See that? You hadn't got to where we need to go. Come on.
Which the Lord your God giveth you.
Come on.
But when ye go over Jordan and dwell in the land which the Lord your God giveth you to inherit.
Yeah.
And when he giveth you rest from all your enemies, yeah, round about.
Uh-huh.
So that ye dwell in safety.
Yeah.
Then there shall be a place which the Lord your God shall choose to cause his name to dwell there.
You know what people don't pay attention to? They had to get clean before they got there. Christians will tell you, you ain't going to live right till you get to him. He just let them know. He just told them they had to stop doing what they were doing. So repentance was already on the scene. Repent means you turn from something. They had to already turn before they got. He said, and you hadn't even got there yet. You hadn't even inherited yet. And he said they had to turn. When we got to stop? Today. He said, you got to stop it today. You see how the word already been said? So when Yeshua would have came on the scene, he would have told them, repent. For the kingdom of Yah is at hand. Hadn't got there yet. You got to turn before it get him. Because Moshe said he's going to be like me. That's what he learned. After John was dead, he came right to the floor, repent. The kingdom of Yah is at hand. Which means you got to stop today before you cross over. In order for us to cross over, we got to take on death. That's the crossover. Y'all hear me? So now when we start to look at these things, these are parameters we're given if you're going to be saved. These Christians been lying for years. They've been telling our foolishness for years, and we come back learning repentance ain't new. Transformation is not new. Doing it in order to receive. We've already been taught this by our law. Come on.
Thither shall ye bring all that I command you.
Come on.
Your burnt offerings and your sacrifices, your tithes and the heave offering of your hand.
Come on.
And all your choice vows which ye vow unto the Lord.
Come on.
And ye shall rejoice before the Lord your God, ye and your sons and
Come
your
on.
Daughters and your men servants and your maid servants and the Levite that is within your gates.
So what happens, son?
For as much as he had no part nor inheritance with
so,
you.
So, come on.
Take heed to yourself.
Then what happens?
Take heed to thyself.
Yeah.
That thou offer not thy burnt offerings in every place that thou seest.
Y'all hear that? You can't do it everywhere you go. Hold on for a minute. They go to church right now. I can serve my God anywhere. I tell you about me. I don't need all them places, Dave. Some people got to go where God told them to go specifically. For me, they, I can do it anywhere. All I need is a list. When I go into the church, I say, surely the Lord is in this place. When I tell you about not going to these churches, all this different stuff, that did not make sense. We can't, he said, which also would make sense at this, at the 137th division of Psalm, at verse 1. So you start seeing patterns of behavior. Where I'm at with these people in these churches now, all the way I'm going in them is to preach to bring you out of them. If you're going to change it, I was supposed to go to Sweden and preach for them in their church. I said, you know what? I ain't got time to go sit in no church, preach nobody, teach nobody. If I go in there, it's to tear it down. Now, if you want to get it torn down, you tell me you want to get it right, I'll come. If you just trying to put me on a little schedule, I ain't just going to no church. I ain't got no business in no church. I can't offer God. He said, I can't offer a big burnt offering everywhere. He said, you can't put that stuff everywhere. Look at 137 division of Psalm. They watch their pattern. If people want to change the trend, I'll come and help you. You want me to just come in there so you can be entertained? So you said Tony Smith came. You're killing time. Yep. I don't care what you're paying. Listen to the book.
By the rivers of Babylon.
There we did what?
Sat down.
And what happened, son?
Yea, we wept.
We wept. And what happened, son?
When we remembered Zion.
When we remembered Zion. Tell them what happened.
We hanged our harps upon the willows.
Because this is what you're supposed to do, Dave. You're supposed to, you, your sons, your men, sir, y'all supposed to come and rejoice before the Lord. If you're going to come and rejoice before the Lord, get what you're going to want to bring, your instruments. He said you can't do it everywhere. Now, don't this make sense? By the rivers of well, there we did what?
We and what sat happened? Down.
And what happened?
Yea, we wept.
And what else?
When we remembered Zion.
But he told her they hung their harps upon the willows. Because you know they look at that. I already know we can't sing them hymn. Because of the discipline of the law, he said you can't get my burnt offering, my offerings everywhere. You can't take my heave offerings everywhere. That's the reason why we got to try to make our way back. Even when it came down to our festive time, we were supposed to come down to keep them. That was to teach us, to let us know. See, this, let me tell you what was happening for us. We had to learn, and these things came to incite us to let us know, this is more now of a drive to get us out of here. Because if you can't do it everywhere, that means we got to leave him. By the rivers of Babylon, what we do, Brandon?
There we sat down.
And what happened, son?
Yea, we wept.
We weren't finna be getting up and dumping around for these niggas.
Amen.
We sat down on them. What else we did?
When we remembered Zion.
When we remembered Zion, what happened?
We hanged our harps upon the willows.
Come on.
In the midst thereof, for there they that carried us away captive.
What did they do?
Required of us a song.
You know what? I wish we could identify with them some kind. Hey, we probably gone through some type of slave trade. We probably, you know what I'm saying? It's hard to identify with them when you don't have nothing in common with them. Y'all know what I'm talking about? Because folk done took them captive. I wouldn't understand that. You know what I'm saying? People would want them to entertain them because amazing when we came over here, they had us entertain them. They love to see us dance. That's why they let us get in the movie and they put us out. I don't tell you, they put us out to dance. They make a whole movie, break dance. Get a white movie, they show white folk dancing the whole time. Probably gonna watch that. They're gonna be tired. Heel, toe, heel, toe. You ain't finna do that for no 2 hours, for no hour and 54 minutes. Man, they gonna be sliding and worming. We gonna be all kinds of stuff, flipping and splitting. Nigga crush grooving. Ain't that right? All that stuff, ain't that right? We tear up a whole hour. Yeah. Man, we wide slap a whole hour. Yeah. No commercial break. Ain't that right? You know what I'm saying? Oh, pick that cotton. Tote. You can't do that stuff not for an hour and 54 minutes. Isn't that right? Man, we did it. Man, we done did everything these folks done gave us. We'll entertain these people for years. But we ain't learned when they say, hey, they got carried away captive, they sat down on them. Come on, son.
And they that wasted us required of us mirth.
And what happened? Want us to be laughing. That's amazing. That's what they do then. Even slave, they want you to be happy. You couldn't be no sad slave. No slave couldn't walk on. White folk didn't play that stuff. Couldn't walk on white folk. Don't play that stuff. Nigga, fix your face. Nigga, look happy. I'll beat you, slept with your wife, raped and sold your kid. Be happy, nigga. They said, man, trying to require us milk. Want laughter from us. What else happened?
Saying, sing us one of the songs of Zion.
We're guilty. The people they brought over here, we didn't think like them. But you know why we didn't think like them? Because before they brought us over here, we had already been dispersed and cut off from our God. See, you go back, and this is how they get you. They got documentation of slave trade. Slave trade shows where they actually went into and took people from. So when you go back and look at the documents of the first slave ship, Jesus, the good Jesus, and all these other ships, you're going to find they got people from around Senegal, outspersed area. Dispersed areas out. You got me? You're not going to see paperwork that's going to say, got you from Jerusalem. That's going to show you other areas because you were already dispersed out of Jerusalem. So when they came to get you and they showed documentation, you saying you're from Yehuda, well, Yehuda would have been in Jerusalem, Bethlehem, and your paperwork don't say that. See how they got you? So we were already dispersed out versus the people that were taken from him from Babylon, taken to Babylon, they weren't from no outspurs city. They were taken directly from Jerusalem. That's why they said we wept when we remember Zion, the city of David. Bethlehem, Judea will be Judea, Yehuda. Y'all got me? So it would be a different, but when they took us, you could see how the plot worked. You didn't have the testimony had. Because you were from Senegal. You were from other dispersed areas that were from around the regions of Africa. So you were already given over to other stuff. You were just like it was when he came and told Azariah, the Lord be with you while you be with him. But if you forsake him, he will forsake you. And now for a long season, Israel had been without, what was it? The true God and without. So they brought us over. We had no teachers. So you see why it was a big part. We came, we started a boat dancing nigga. We were still to get that boom, 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 boom. Because you had already lost it. When you're taking people directly out of there who had the discipline, it's going to be harder to break them. It's be hard. Like men like Daniel, Azariah, all those different ones, the three Hebrew boys, it was hard to break them. Because they done came from free land. So you trying to come tell me about you finna play some flute, clarinet, harp, and that. Remember what everybody had to do? You had to fall down. They see her looking, saying, I ain't falling down. I'm not worse with us. We jump straight up at a play. Look at a nigga sit around and just play his lead to a flag. All that contrary to what you've been taught. You supposed to tear that junk down. You're supposed to quick destroy these people. All the way we do, we sit right there, we play, we go volunteer for these people. They don't even ask if we volunteer now. Now you had to drag a nigga down to fight for him. Muhammad Ali would look that unpatriotic. Muhammad Ali, as stupid a nigga he was in that wrong religion, tried to tell y'all over and over. He said, ain't none of the people that call me nigga. He said, why am I going to go fight some more oppressed people? Muhammad Ali told you that. He said, people ain't did nothing to me. He said, the people in America, the one got me. You have no documentation when them people ever call you nigga. When North Korea ever came out and made a comment about blacks? Derogatory. The man bring y'all over to North Korea and let y'all play basketball for him. Man bring ex-star that can't even get proper insurance or Medicare from the league that done broke them down. And he bring on and let them play for him and pay them big money. Call him along, nigga ain't finna get nothing. Danny Robin washed up. He bring them and let them play. I mean, that thing, he hate everybody. So how he let them fly in here? The man kill everybody around him. He don't trust them. But he bring black faces over him, let them come and entertain him and pay them and watch movies with him. They said the man got thousands of these movies. He got over 2,000 movies in his collection. His daddy was ready to negotiate with us and break off and make a treaty with South Korea. We wouldn't do what he asked for. Who remember what he asked for? He said he wanted to play Batman. Y'all laughing. He told him. He said, let me play Batman. I'll do it. That a fat joke. I'd have paid it while there. I don't even go to the movie. I guarantee that I've been standing my black monkey behind niggas stuff in that line, though. That fat joke, I'd be like, rewind it back. I want to see it one more time. These people, they tell you hate us. None of these people hate you. These serving men and women tell you, those blacks that's over them kind of people over there, they don't have a fight with us. Nobody hates you. They give you a name and tell you those people hate them because of what they've done to them. They hate them because they look at you saying, I don't ever want to be. They try to figure, why would you be on your knees praying to the same person they pray to? How they thinking? You do know you've been taken captive. Man, we're in bad shape. I don't know how they make it. I mean, it's a crime to take a dog. Train a dog to fight another. Just happen that y'all two dogs. I'm going to take him, cut you loose. I got my chain. Take you out your cage. I'm going to let you get in the ring. You're going to fight her. As soon as you get through, you want to pat you on your head. I'm going to put you back in your cage. Now, that's only because you're a dumb animal. That's the only reason he does it, because he's a dumb animal. He's not looking at it. This dog don't have no fight with you. You're fighting and killing for me. I'm going to profit from this. You won't get nothing, and I'm going to put you back in your cage. That sounds like us. And do you not know that's a crime? You can get prison time. Who's charging these white people for taking blacks and putting them in the military, having them fighting folks, and then putting them back in their cages? How is that not a crime? When you get back and you're still a nigga. Just being honest, how did that make you feel to know that they took a man who murdered 9 innocent people? He said, I'm hungry. You pull up at Burger King and buy him something to eat. Now, this ain't even speculation. I know you didn't hold that burger to his mouth, which means you took his handcuffs off and you let this man sit and eat while you watched him. What did that tell you about these people's minds? Let me ask you something. Why is it not a story about this police officer being in court? Why he, Brother Captain, what should have happened? Termination. Had you stopped a black guy and went, took him to Burger King and got on the news and let him eat some who murdered 9 people, would you have still kept your job? Y'all ain't seen that nigga story, have you? How would anybody want to stay here and fight for these people? Anybody with this skin color? How would you ever have any confidence in them? How would you put a judge on a scene that let them sit there and say, listen, his parents are victims? Why is it every time when white people do something to their parents, their whole family be victims? Whenever we do something, nobody even talk about our family. Trayvon family wasn't even victims. Man, I love that play. I'm like, you sure how I wish it were already burning. This is, it's scary. That white people actually think like that? Ain't even about race. 9 human beings were gunned down. And you sit here think it was okay to stop and feed him Burger King? But then, like I said, you got white prisoner with life in prison. One cut up a human being, another one killed a police officer, and they bring him food from home. I mean, it all makes sense. I mean, you've been told the white woman having sex with him. Well, we investigated, but just the mere mention that an employee has sex, whole everything shutting down. You got to shut everything down, find what's going on. Oh, they've been having sex for years. What's going on with these people? Then we got to hear, she's cooperating. Everything she's telling her has been very instrumental in catching her, even though we hadn't caught her. Where we at? We right up on her. I mean, stop it. How many y'all catch it because now they make a stupid mistake? You ain't even smart enough to catch nobody. Right. They been way off. They been, oh, we right around the prison. They ain't escaped. They ain't even 2 miles from the prison. That nigga 15 miles up the road. They been in cabin, whole money, them bought shotguns and everything. They told her they were 2 miles around the prison. Oh, they still wet too. from climbing through the sewer. That nigga rode out in the car. These people are dangerous. Again, this is why we look at the importance of the word to show up. There's no way we can stay him. There is no way we can stay him with a clear conscience. The only way to stay in their place actually is to sit down and don't believe in God. The one desire to stay here is not to believe in God. To want somebody to sit around and molest you and beat you and manipulate, that's crazy. But our forefather, the mind they had. Come on, finish this up, son.
And they that wasted us required of us mirth.
Come on,
sing
us to laugh. Sing us what?
Sing us one of the songs.
Oh, y'all know what happened with your jaw? Them white folk, that white son that look and say, what's wrong with you? What's going on? You ain't happy here? They don't like it when you ain't happy. When you happy, that means you're good with the propaganda. Come on. That's why they get upset. They don't like when you sit around and you don't look happy. But like some, what's wrong with you? You're different around here. Y'all going there laughing nigga all the time. Me and my wife were talking about that morning. Y'all laughing nigga with these folk, playing with these folk, telling these folk too much information. One would tell me, looked up an employee, told her employer, I know how much you make, it's public record. I'd have never told nobody white nothing like that. You don't tell white people stuff. That white folk come and say, you black. I never go to nobody white and tell them I looked at how much they make. Man, that's assassinate. That's a bullet in my head. White people say, what I say? The nigga is searching out what we make. I tell y'all some smart stuff. Y'all don't play with these people like what you know, last thing you keep to yourself. You don't need people in job. I teach y'all be Muslim. No, you don't never tell white people know what they made. Hey, you know what? I ain't got a clue. But like one time I got locked up, man, and one of the brother, man, he got locked, nigga crazy. He dead, and that nigga straight crazy. He told the police, he said, man, I get out. He said, I'm gonna steal your car, I'm gonna steal. That player got that joke. He said, y'all stop that joke ahead of car. He said, boom. He said, you seen that? That police all look at me. I said, man, he seen nothing. I tell him, I ain't seen nothing. He snapped that nigga head. That nigga said, scow. He said, you seen that? I said, man, I ain't seen nothing. Now, you know, just snap that joker head into the hood of that car. Now, what you think gonna do to my head? You ain't seen nothing. Isn't that right? Man, you think I'm crazy? Handcuffed, I'm tell that way, but I seen it. No, I ain't seen nothing. Y'all all right? Y'all always, let me tell you something y'all do with these homies. Y'all got to learn how to have a real limited conversation on a lot of stuff. Y'all learn how to go on your work, go on your job, do your job. Don't overpush yourself because you overcommit yourself and you're going to be stuck. Once I learn you can do the job before men, you'll never drop down to 2 or 3. It's impossible. I'm going to fire you. I'm going to fire you. I'm going to have a right call because you ain't been performing. You go on your job, you one man, you do the job of one man. Y'all hear me? You work just and you work on it. Don't ever put yourself out there, you're going to pay. When you push yourself that hard, make sure you're working for yourself. I'm better with you. Don't never. That stuff I did, I'm telling you, I done it. No way for you to stick me in it with my own stupid fault. I used to go out the first time I came out working for R&L Gator. That man gave me a route. I came for food, so I was used to running. I came back. That fella came and got me. He called me. He said, come on. He got them time. He said, look at this. He said, do you see these times on their paperwork? Because I had to write the times down everywhere I got them places. I had never ran the route before. He said, ain't nobody never ran. I was like, I didn't get it. What was the big deal? Them niggas kept telling me. They said, you better slow down. Man, them folks put me out there. I would listen. Them joker would start me out in Ellenwood, Georgia, right off 675. I would run all the way up to Tennessee and back down. Delivering. Then I got a load and come back and finish up in Marietta. Shoot, I do that before the sunset. I hit her, then I come back down. Choo-choo. Listen, them fellas come by there, give me that tell them folks, get Tony Smith for your trailer. When I fill up my trailer, I'm getting ready to go. They say, stop. They tell me, Tony Smith, grab his trailer and finish fill up his trailer. They grab my trailer and roll in. Them joker riding every day with a full trailer. Man, they been on 3-hour lunch break, sitting, chilling. I got their trailer, I'm still running, filling them up. Listen, I come in, dog, leave, dog. Realize something. I shot my done self. Being so darn smart, real running, I shot myself and I ran another to get fired. Because soon you start trying to stop that jump, your behind get questioned. They ain't expecting that out of nobody else. Everybody else was doing the same thing. They took their time. Forged the time. They set a play. They just said, I'd be like, man, I got to get this. I'm diving out the back of the truck. Instead of walking my behind, oh, yeah. Old guy got me one. He said, come here. He said, what you do? I said, I got to go look. He said, don't you never do that again. I was like, what? He said, you don't jump your behind off this dock. He said, you walk your behind around the wall. I said, I got to go. I got to hurry up and get these trailers. All right, got me. Hit my nigga suicide. I ain't jumping down. You jump up in the air. You done all that knee shot. I'm doing an extra nigga jump. Like you been doing a long jump. Mofo, you know you bend down and jump down. Not me, I'm nigga. Jumping ankle. Legs kicking. I learned then. After you burn yourself, D4, after you run yourself to death, all you gonna do, your jaw always gonna be the one question. The rest of the sorry folk, they ain't doing nothing. They safe. Because they used to them not doing. Them folk learn coming in there, be smart. Don't overstress yourself. Do just enough. Don't run through nothing too fast. You're like, done. Shoot yourself. Them folk just sit down. Pick. They be like, you ain't done yet. Almost. Pick. Here you are. Everybody take 15-minute break. I got to get through. Everybody else, I'm taking my break. Whatever ain't going to get done. That's why I got a whole week of work. You done knocked yours out in 3 days. You could take off 2. They cut my hour. You done cut your own hour. You done everybody else work in here. Why them sorry for? They smart. A lot of I learn. You know, I look at them folks. You learn when you get older. You learn to keep your mouth shut on certain stuff. You learn how to go in and do your job, and you don't overstress yourself. You will stick yourself. Anybody get stressed, I'm worried about the company. The company won't worry about itself. I done all that stuff. One time, you'll be more worried about their company they'll be. You go in there, you work smart. You get them folks to just work. Every break you entitled to, you take it. I used to work with a black lady one time. You know how they came. I was working when they had the pads right where you can go smoke cigarette. Every time they go out, she go outside. Listen, they take a cigarette break, she take one. She didn't even smoke. So listen, man, we been a dying laughing. She sat down with listen, they be working to them and look at each other, sitting there, look like that. They'll be like, they'll walk out, they'll get their cigarette. She'll stop working. She'll go sit outside the chair set right there and watch them. They'll smoke, they'll be looking. Then they be talking, they be thinking. This nigga don't smoke. They'll put them cigarette and go back. Then she'll go back in. We were like, why you do that? She said, every time they take a cigarette break, I'm gonna take one. Every time. But listen, they be so mad with her, they'll try to hurry and get to pull her back to work. She'll go with the supervisor. If they took a break, she took one. Man, we be inside. I ain't tried. But I'm telling you, man, you'd die. We be in a dying laugh. And I mean, she'll sit in their face and watch the whole time they smoking. She said, she got smart. She said, these jokers get to stop work when they want to smoke. I ain't working either. Walk right out there with them and smoke. Like, why you don't smoke? I'm just inhaling. I can help a lot of y'all out. Y'all better cut out the extra, these niggas little tricks y'all be doing these jokes. The reason why I'm telling y'all now, I've done them. Please don't think I'm saying it because I hadn't done them. At the end, when you burn yourself out for running for these people, after you get through killing your doing self, the company will still run. I thought they weren't going to run without me either. They doing real good. They don't call me and say, with me back in there. They get somebody, some other nigga come through do that trick I did. And the one that sat back, that lady who I think should have been fired, they getting ready to retire soon. They appreciate it too. They let you know, I see folk like you. You don't last long. Them folk running ain't going to try to do the whole company and all your boss stuff. It's all I can do to do what I'm doing. I can think about it now. Don't they give you more work? Because you know what? You deserve it. You don't know that Joe work, Leon work, and Adler work? Why don't you go ahead and get your kid and Brittany work too? Riley, you got some stuff you ain't finna get there before you know it. Now what happened? After you get through doing all that work and you mess around, you can't do it. Gotta let you go. It ain't me. And if you ever need anything, call me. You know what that mean? I swear to God I ain't gonna answer the phone. I tell you, I know what it mean. If you need, I just fired you. Why would you call me? Why would I help you? You needed help by keeping your job. I ain't calling you, nigga. Tell me no junk like that. Call me if you ever need anything. I need a job. Why you fired me? That to get you out of the property without any shoe. Now, all this is being told to y'all, so now y'all get smart. Ain't that right, Snap? These folks get on these jobs, they'll love these people. They'll marry these folks. I told all y'all go to these jobs, keep your dresses down and your pants up. Don't be wearing your shirt and button down here when folks see the little splits. All you gonna be doing is hoeing on the job. Well, anything y'all going to job, you ain't none of us going on these jobs. And I said, none of us gonna be doing nothing new. Ain't somebody done. If you got a job, you know, always remember this, if you wanted to start a company, somebody was doing what you were doing before you got there. However, if you wasn't at the start of it now, you do know somebody was doing what you were doing before you got there. So you get on these jobs, you got to learn something. But start having sex with these people. Y'all learning here to go ahead. I've been told y'all to go to these jobs to do what I told y'all supposed to do. Infiltrate. What is it? What is it? Bell minimum. Oh, why is it bell minimum? Think of when I said bell minimum. They got to hold a hold of bell minimum. No. I wouldn't say bare minimum. You want to go in and give people a just work for you, what you do. But you got to learn what you're involved. Don't get me. It's going to be situations that are going to come that you will have to do sometime more, involve yourself. But when you ain't got to, don't be stupid. Don't keep me in the person them people can count on. It's going to hurt you later. Because when everybody else get to go home and be with their family, Leon, I know you got to go, but I need you to stay. Now he want to man up. He ain't going to stay. He got to go. Me and other wife, we look at each other, drop them glasses down. Do you know what it means? Leon finna start getting the silent treatment. We finna start trying to get you out the door. I'm telling you now, they smooth now. Let me tell you something. The human resource rule, they don't fight them. They know how to get rid of you. All I got to do is listen. It's easy to get rid of you. I ain't finna do nothing to him. I'm finna get behind some of my work. He'll quit. What are you going to go and tell the EOC? I gave him too much work. This is going to be a good one. He going to go tell unemployment people, I gave him too much work. And he quit. How much money you think they finna get him? Nothing. Because they going to be looking at, he quit. Y'all got it? All I got to do is keep shooting them, night a little write up, and get Leon to sign them. Start me a paper trail on Leon. Y'all don't be thinking y'all be playing with these people. Once y'all turn around and start trying to stand up and y'all start realizing you getting beat, you done then. You done. So y'all got to start getting smart when y'all do something. Y'all learn how to liquidate a little bit at a time. Learn how to get smart. You know where you stuck at. Don't take on no more now. I tell them, folks, I so appreciate it, though. I like to be able to do it, though. You don't know how much I like to be able to do it. But I'm not going to be able to do it. You got to be real smart. Tell them, still trying to finish up this with a guy. When I get through with it, I get to it. And if you want to leave it. When they set that leave, you ain't never get to it. I ain't never get through. So you caught on, ain't never get through. Isn't that right? They come, you got to say, I wish I had some more hands. So you don't know how I wish I was an octopus. I wouldn't just want, I wouldn't do everybody at the job work. It'd be somebody saying, that nigga, that real dedicated. But there's no way that nigga had eight on exactly. But I'm going to just say how stupid you are. Y'all have to be smart when y'all dealing with these people. Once you don't start putting too much out, start doing too much, now you got to start looking at how you transition. And if you get you a chance to go somewhere else and start working, you start to come in the right way. You come in doing your job. Stuff not job description, stuff not doing, you got to start watching because you get trapped now. And once you get trapped one time, they're going to tell you, well, really, your job description is everything we give you. Isn't that right? Now you're doing everything. Now you're the tissue toter, butt wiper, sneeze cleaner. All right, why are they going to get you now? You gotta learn how to do it. You go in what you want to ask people for. Y'all don't ask. And you gotta, if you got a real job, you want to get a description of your, get it at the beginning. Now, after that stuff later on, then they start getting you stuff. Now I'm gonna finna fire you because you're a smart nigga. So, you know, man, I get a copy of my description to do this because I want to make sure I'm doing everything you want me to do. You get that and you file and you keep it. So now when you have the man or woman up on their behind, they come some junk, you get to pull that paper out and say, not in my description. So when you fire me, now I got your behind. Because when I shoot that down to the unemployment people, they see, that wasn't in their description to do this. They shouldn't have been. See, y'all don't know nothing about these jobs. Y'all, you know what they think? I'm the nigga. How long of them think they be smarter than me? Go ahead and tell the truth. I know y'all think y'all be smarter than me. They do think they know more. They be so bad. You know what they think right now? I don't know nothing. I'm a nigga. Reason why I know, because these folks done burnt me before. You get that beginning, you get it going. You let them know you want to get it because you want to be the best employee they got. I want to make sure I'm doing everything I'm supposed to do. You getting that to cover your behind when they come and try to shoot you some junk, they ain't got no business. When y'all have conversation, they catch you up and they try to get you on stuff, you start notate dates and time. You start know who was there. You keep your pen, you keep your little pen, you always keep your pen or pencil. That stuff start, how they start in that stupid stuff, you be saying, no, write it down so you can start showing the history when stuff start changing. On this date, June 26th, Boston started cutting the food when he asked me to do and was not in my job description, and I explained to it was not, and I have a copy of it. Now we got some reason to start showing where the change came. We stuck a, I want to say it was a Sunday, but you work Monday through Friday. I'm wrong. It was Monday. At that anytime, once you come, you wrong. You done. Nobody going to defend that case. Nobody. I want to say it was a Tuesday or a Friday. There's no way you can pull that. No, listen, if you sit on a stand, you say that, they're going to pull you right out. You just hurt somebody's case. You always keep your pad and keep your pencil. Or a pen, anything go, you want to just make sure you get it. Catch that time, you know what the date is, you shoot right on out as soon as you got to start. No, don't pull this out in front of these people because you're going to get fired. As soon as you can get away, you want to make sure you remember as much detail or conversation, who was talking, who was listening, who was there in the room, what approximate time was it when it happened. You start keeping your notepad. That's how you cover your behind. Y'all got me? I can help y'all with a whole lot of stuff. But a lot of y'all, y'all be too smart for me. If y'all only had like, feel, y'all done peaked out, I mean, it feel great. This stuff be coming set for you. Y'all good? I ain't gonna be able to hold y'all. I still have some more to teach up. I ain't gonna hold y'all any longer. So y'all been educated, you know your Hebrew. So we're gonna go over it again. Name for Genesis. Bereshith. Y'all got it? How we spell it? Yeah, you can do it. You got two spellings, B-E-R-E, accent, S-H-I-T, one spelling. Second spelling, B-E-R-E-I, S-H-I-T-H. Y'all got me? Exodus, Shema, first spelling. S H E M O T. First spelling. Second spelling, S H E M O T H. Now let me say this too. You can also go S H M O T H. Because a lot of times with the E, you start dealing with English discipline of vowels. A lot of stuff can't be proven. Just like the name Samuel. Samuel will actually be spelled S-H-M-U-E-L, Shemuel, Shemuel, it's not Samuel, S-H-M-U-E-L, Shemuel, but they taught us Samuel, because their pronunciation, they try to use vowels. Y'all got me? So y'all got Shemuel, S-H M-U-E-L. Okay? Now we got Leviticus. V-A-Y-I-Q-R-A. Varica. V as in Victor, A, Y, I, Q, R, A. Yeah. Vayuraqua. V, A, there'll be a dash so you know to pronounce that part. Then Y, I, Q, R, A. Okay? And what does that mean? Call. What does the Shemoth mean? Names. What does Bereshith mean? Beginning or start. Okay, numbers. Bamidbar. B E M I D B A R. Who? What did they say? I said for numbers. What did we say it mean? We ain't said what it meant. Wilderness. What did I just say? Yeah, that's for Numbers. It means wilderness. The name for Numbers is Bamidbar. That means wilderness. I'm saying, what is, yeah, didn't I tell y'all that? He said, that means wilderness. I'm like, yeah, what happened? I thought I missed. Yeah, that's wilderness. But that's the word actually instead of the word Numbers. Okay? Our last word, Deuteronomy. Devarim. How we spell it? Hold on. Oh, don't look down. What you just spell? Is that D-E-V-A-R-I-M. D-E-V-A-R-I-M. And y'all got Yeshayah. Y-E-S-H-A-Y-A-H. Yeshayah. Then y'all got Jeremiah. Y-I-R-M-Y-A-H. Jeremiah. Matthew, M-A-T-T-I-T-Y-A-H. So we got that. Man, y'all some Hebrew-speaking people in here now. We're getting to get a lot of hand claps. Thank the Lord. Thank the Lord. Thank the Lord. That's good, brother. Thank the Lord. Thank the Lord. Man, y'all learned a lot of words today, didn't you? Y'all did good, didn't it? We moving our way, ain't we? Y'all doing real good. So for those that are watching at home, hopefully you got a chance to write it down and to get it, or go back over the video, make sure you write them down, make sure you get it. So when we get ready to put the books together, we'll make sure we're putting them down. Also, y'all need to remember Nineveh, fifth grade, N-E-V-I, accent, I-M, Nineveh, that means the prophets. N-E-V-I, accent, that's a little slash at the top. Of the I, or between them, I am. Nineveh, that means the prophets. N-E-V, accent, I am. Nineveh, that means the prophets. So we go back and start looking at Jeremiah and the different ones. Yeshayah, those are called the Ninevehs. Y'all got it? That means the prophets. Then you want to remember the Kitavim, K-E-T-H-U-I-M, Kitavim. K-E-T-H-U-I-M, Kitavim, Kitavim. I don't think it has the V in it. I don't think it has the V. We'll go back and check on that. I can't be perfect now. It's like Andre said now. I got to misspell my name or something now. But let's go with K-E-T-H-U. I think it might be V-I-M. Kithavim. K-E-T-H. K-E-T-H-U-V-I-M. Kithavim. And this would mean the writings. So we call for the Kitavims, we're going to go to the writings. The Ninevehs are the prophets. The Tanakh is going to be your whole book. Nineveh, N-E-V-I, accent, I-M. Two eyes. No, the Tanakh is going to be the whole book. Torah will be the first five books. The Tanakh will be consistent of the Torah and all the other books. It's actually believed that that the reason you get the word Tanakh is from the breakdown of the three words, the Torah, the Ninevim, and the Kitavim. Y'all got me? So that's how they believe you actually have the Tanakh. T-A. T-A-N-A-K-H. So the T-A supposed to stand for the Tanakh. The N-A supposed to be for the Ninevim. And the K-H is supposed to be for the Kitavim. Y'all got me? What Old Testament? It'd be the law. Old Testament is actually not something we would use. Actually, for Yehudian, we would actually not call it the Old Testament. It's actually the law. Remember what he told y'all, and which would make sense if you look at the 10th chapter, y'all were taught this in the 36th verse of the book of St. John. He said, is it not written in your Old Testament? I said. We'll say it's in the Old Testament. That's not what he said. He said it's in your law. Y'all got it? So we have something to kind of bag what we say. You won't ever find anybody in the New Testament said in the Old Testament. None of the writers wrote that. They would say in the law. Isn't that right? So it makes sense? So we'll try to stop referring. When we write, we won't put Old Testament. We'll just put the law. It'd be the writing, the Kitavims and the Ninevims. Y'all got it? Man, y'all so Hebraic. I'm just going to get some Yiddish. So we can get it out of him. Huh? The writings are going to be like the prophets, the minor prophets. They'll be up under like the Proverbs, Psalms, Ecclesiastics, Lamentation. Stuff like that will be your writings. You got me? The reason why you look at the prophets are going to consist of what they consider to be your major prophets. Yeshayah, Jeremiah, Ezekiel, those are what they consider to be major prophets. Y'all got me? Even you get with Samuel, even Chronicles will be with the writings. Chronicles will be with the writings. Y'all got it? So we got stuff that's in our writings, and we got stuff that we consider as the prophets. Not that a prophet didn't give us Psalms and others, but it's just considered to be in our writings. Y'all got it? We would never put David's book with the major prophet, because we really looked at David as a king. Y'all got it? He wasn't just a prophet for us. He was a king. Oh, thank the Lord. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. T-A-N-A-K-H. T-A going to stand for the Torah, N-A for the Ninevim, and the K-H is for the Kitavim. That's what's believed now, how they got the word Kanah. So it's going to consist of Torah, Ninevim, Kitavim. That's why you had a word Tanakh. Y'all got it? That makes sense for y'all? So if you got the Tanakh, there's no way to have the Tanakh and not have the Torah. There's no way to have the Tanakh and not have the Ninevim. There's no way to have the Tanakh and not have the Kitavim. I got a Tanakh, it don't have the Torah. Then you don't have a Tanakh. You just got a knocker. Got it? You might agree then. Is he going to take it up now? Joseph, please don't run off with that money. I think you don't have a problem when you got to put that money down. So y'all got how many different words? How many words y'all got that ain't new words? Twelve? How many you say about that balloon? Oh, I thought she said five. How many I got? 10? Somebody got 12. 12? So how you only got 10? What you didn't write down? Oh, because I gave y'all the two spellings for the, that's got 12. Without the double speller. The only way I gave y'all, because there's two ways you can spell it. That's why I was giving y'all the two ways that you can spell it. So those shouldn't count as separate words, but it's still kind of same pronunciation. So you should have 12. What words you got so we can see what you're missing? Hold on, let me hear what words you got. Y'all count them out. I mean, see, we'll find out what he's missing. Yeshayah, that's one. Bereshit, Shemot, Barika, Bayikra, Bamidbar, Devarim, Jeremiah, who? Shemuel for Samuel. Ninevim, Kithavim, and the Tanakh. The Torah. Well, the Torah is going to be your first five books. You can have the Torah without having a Tanakh. The Torah is just going to be your first five books, which is going to be a word used as Pentateuch. Don't ask me how to spell that. You're going to mess up. We can't keep pushing the button. Oh, she's been trying to get ahead, Marcus. Shemot. Okay, the Hebrew title. Shemot. Oh, she's been trying to get ahead. Oh, that's a preacher Bible. Oh, her Bible had in the top of it too, Shemot. But you didn't know that though, did it? You didn't know that when? Oh, okay, up in her note. It got footnotes in your Bible. So it had the name up there. Hers is with the M-O-T-H. Or the M-O. I think they used the H for simply for the sound. Because when they pronounced the S-H-E-M-O-T, well, we would say Shemot. Because we'll try to sign out the T. It just says Shemot. So the T won't have so much of a sound here, the H on the end. So I think some people spell it with an H because they feel like the sound. We got to always remember, ancient Hebrew wouldn't have wrote letters sound the way we would spell things. A lot of times we try to discipline things to English, so that's why sometimes the spelling's going to be different. They're trying to go with way of sound. These are the letters we use. A lot of things they wouldn't have done. Y'all got me? So we still learning, transitioning, and making sure we're keeping that discipline. So we don't want to get so much English discipline on Hebrew stuff, and now we're saying Hebrew pronounced it wrong. Then you need to be slapped in your mouth. Isn't that right? Because they would have had their pronounce, because that's a language differing from everybody else's language. So why would their words sound like our words? Wouldn't make sense to get them a language with the words sounding like English. And the words sound like Aramaic. They already speak Aramaic. You see what I'm saying? So make sure y'all kind of keep in mind as we do this, we're trying to make sure we stay lined in, okay? And when we get messed up with it, I'm telling you, this is how you pronounce, because you're a vowel sound, because then you'll need to get slapped. Who going to spell y'all YH? No language going to spell it YH, but that's what it is. It's YH. They gave it to us YAH because they're going with the sound of it. It was YH. That's the name. He gave them the name. YH, WH, YHVH. This stuff not going to be. Our Y going to be different. Here's a yod, hey, vo, hey. Y-O-D, V-A-V. No, Y-O-D-H-E-Y, V-A-V-H-E, Y-H-V-H. So his sounds are going to be a little different than how we kind of put our stuff together. Y'all got me? They Y ain't going to say Yod. Our Y-O-D for the Y. Hey, H-E-Y. Vav, V-A-V for the W, and the H, H-E-Y, Y-H-W-H, Y-H-V-H. So those are how the sound be broken down. The Y sound, Y-O-D for the Y, H-E-Y for the H, V-A-V should be for the W or for the V. And H-E again for the H. Yahweh Vohe. Y-O-D. Y'all really pushing me today. Y-O-D for the Y. Should be H-E-Y for the H. For the W and the V, y'all always hear me tell y'all, YHWH, YHVH, because it's dependent on where it's used. Y'all got me? What's argument is the fact that it's believed that the YHVH is actually being used more than the YHWH. The YHVH is supposed to be more his connection with man. When they talk about how God created man, YHVH is what they say would have been properly put there. We don't put it there because he hadn't gave it to him at that time. But you got to remember, Moshe would have written the Pentateuch, which means five books. Five. Pentateuch is five. So he would know the words. You got me? That makes sense. He don't use it there because of the fact that it had been given to him in Genesis. So when he would have wrote, and he wrote concerning Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, he would have never put the name there for him. Because they wouldn't have known it. It wouldn't have made sense to give it to him, let him use it. Then come over in the second chapter when you jump on the scene and say they didn't know it, but then you used it in Bereshit. Y'all got me? Y'all follow me? Y'all look kind of... Did I explain myself? Moshe is responsible for the first five books, Torah. Torah would be from correct teaching. Teaching or instructions. That's what your Torah would be. Teaching or instructions. Now, Moshe is responsible for these books. Now, when Moshe would have came back and would have written the book of Bereshit, which is called Genesis, he wouldn't have used the name there when it came to the fathers talking with him. When he would have wrote conversation with the fathers, having conversation with the Most High, he would have never used the name because they didn't know the name. All they know was El. He used Elohim, but it's believed. Y'all got me? Or let me say, when I say it's believed, it's speculated. It's been said that YHVH would have been properly used when it come down to saying his connection to man. Y'all got me? So YHWH is used, YHVH is used. They're not always used. Like, you'll get a lot of people, they'll put YHWH through the whole book. YHWH is not believed to be mainly used. It's believed that YHVH was mainly used. Y'all got me? There's a difference when you use these two. So I was kind of giving y'all the sounding of how the letters are spelled for the sounds. The Y-O-D, yod, for the Y. Hey, for the W, I mean for the H, Y, which is H-E-Y. Vol, I want to say V-A-V, for the W or for the V. Hey, again, for the H, H-E-Y. These letters, what I'm spelling, are the sounds. Yod. YHWH, YHVH, the Y, YOD, the H, HEY, the V or the W, VAV, and the H, HEY. Yah-he-vo-he, which be the pronunciation sounds of the letters to make. That makes sense? Now, if you took English and do it, they wouldn't do it that way, would they? My school teacher, I ain't here but one of them. Right? They wouldn't do that, would it? Wouldn't make sense. So it wouldn't make sense that their words would sound like English words, then, would it? Wouldn't make sense to try to pronunciate their words with English discipline. Hold on, because the Y got, see, that's going to mess you up. When you start this, so you spell, we spell y'all Y-A-H. Because we try to go with the sound. It don't make sense. YH wouldn't do that. So our discipline, because English is going to be YAH, but it doesn't make sense. It would just make sense, YH. That's where he did it. That's what he gave to him. It's called a tetragrammaton, which means the four letters. The four letters of his name. That's what it's called, a tetragrammaton. Okay? So a lot of times you got to watch a lot of English discipline because it messes you up. Because our English grammar going to have a discipline of Greek. So you got to be real careful. Is everybody good with that? So I know sometimes you can look at something and say, that would be, because that, uh-uh, because then we can argue. Because you're going to look at English, what do you know English discipline, vowels. So you're going to try to pronounce from that spectrum, and you're going to wind up messing up. So we do the YAH because that's what people more commonly to looking at saying, oh, yeah. You said, that's just YH. Because you start putting English discipline in a lot of stuff. Y'all got me? And it makes a difference. Y'all got me? They're like, Shamuel. We would probably spell it S-H-E-M-U-E-L. But it's spelled S-H-S-H-M-U-E-L. Shumiel, we would put S-H-E, wouldn't we? Because you're going to look at, if I pronounce it like that, you're going to say, oh, S-H-E. No, S-H. If you said a letter missing. Because you're looking at English discipline. Y'all got me? See, in Hebrew, I'm a genius. Y'all get me over here? I'm just a dumb nigga. You take me back where I'm from. Rhodes Scholar. Y'all hear me? Give me the English stuff. I don't know what they put. I'm like, Kerry, you remember that time they tried to say we were delisted? Man, we was in chapter one. Now he don't remember. No, we read from right to left. It makes sense now. So I just want y'all to kind of consider that when we're looking at these words, don't try to go with, oh, that don't look right, because it should be spelled. We got to kind of break away from the conformity of you're looking at English discipline. This is not English. This is Hebrew. Hebrew is different than any of the other languages. So our letters going to be pronounced differently than you're going to look at how they're going to do it. Y'all got me? And sometimes we spell it the way it actually sounds, but that's not actually how it's spelled. Y'all got me? Make sense? Because we're going to go away. If you tell somebody that, you're going to try to spell it from sounds or how English letters are versus Hebrew. Okay? So we're going to try to get through this. Y'all work with me. Y'all got me? This is a lot of work. But we can do it, right? By the grace of the Most High, YH. Isn't that right? Through his son, Yeshua HaMashiach. All right, let's give it a stand. Get a lot of hand clapping.